Hi everyone! In this video we are going to provide a tutorial on how to utilize the electronic flight bag, or EFB, to calculate takeoff performance data in the Boeing 787-10 for Microsoft Flight Simulator. This feature will be arriving for all players using the Premium Deluxe edition of the simulator in Sim Update 13, scheduled for September 28th. We have already created our flight plan and used the new SimBrief automation options to load our fuel, payload, and flight plan into the aircraft. If you missed that video and would like to learn this step, please click the link on the video screen now or check out the description below. Once at the stage of your pre-flight procedures where you have completed the Perf Init page on the CDU, focus on the EFB located to the left of the captain's seat or to the right of the first officer's seat, if you prefer. Press the Initialize Flight button, then followed by the Performance button. This will bring up our Performance Takeoff page. Next, press Copy FMC Data, and you will find that the QNH, the takeoff weight, and the zero fuel weight will be populated. Please note that the QNH box will only show what you have selected via the EFIS panel, so please ensure that this is correct for your current weather conditions. To enter in the correct CG, or center of gravity, move back to the CDU, press Index, Settings, Weight and Balance, and then see the CG Act figure. Today, as is 31.5, so we can enter that into the EFB. You can now proceed with the rest of the selectable boxes in the Performance Takeoff page of the EFB. Ensure the airport and runway are correct for your flight. Select the conditions. Today is a dry day in Singapore. Next, type in the winds. Today, 340 degrees at 3 knots, and the outside air temperature, today, 26 degrees centigrade. From here, we can go to the RTG, or rating box. I usually select optimum so that the aircraft can decide based on the parameters that we have provided whether to use full thrust or to derate the engines during takeoff. I also select optimum on the flap config, and on the anti-ice config, I usually leave in engine auto. You can now press calc in the top corner, and the EFB will automatically create your takeoff data. Once loaded, we can see that the aircraft has selected a flap 5 departure today, with a V1 speed of 155 knots, a VR, or rotate speed, of 159 knots, and a V2 speed of 166 knots. The ATM text in the background here stands for the assumed temperature method. Today, our assumed temperature, our selected temperature, is 44 degrees centigrade. We have got a TO2 derate today as well. Please don't be concerned if this all sounds very overwhelming. There is a lot of data here. The final step is to now select the Send Output button in the bottom left corner. We can now move back to the CDU, where a message will appear asking us to accept or reject the takeoff data uplink by the takeoff ref page. To do this, select Init Ref, Thrust Limb, Takeoff, and then Accept. You will now see the takeoff speeds, the selected temperature, and the derate, alongside our flap setting, which have automatically populated the boxes from the EFB data. Finally, press the line select key to the left of CG twice to enter in our center of gravity, and this will now provide us with a trim setting for takeoff. You have now correctly used the EFB to calculate takeoff performance for your flight in the Boeing 787-10 and entered the information into the CDU. We hope you found this video informative and look forward to seeing you all enjoying this new feature in Sim Update 13.